room. I can't help stopping stare. Show me what you got. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Gal. If you guys are new to this channel, I do video editing, production, photo, as well as audio tutorials on this channel. And today I'm showing you how to create that cool freeze frame character introduction effect that you guys saw in the beginning here. And what's really cool about this effect is it's a very popular tool to introduce characters in your films and kind of comic book style action films. It's been done a lot. Now, in addition to creating the freeze frame effect, I also overlaid some hand painted elements. Now, a couple weeks ago, I made a full tutorial on how to use this awesome hand painted elements and title pack by Smashworks. I'll put a link in the description box below so you guys can check it out. What's really great about these is you can just drag and drop them from your central graphics panel and they take just seconds to use. So I'll show you how I use them in this tutorial towards the end of the tutorial. And yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. Okay, so here we are in Premiere Pro. The first step here is to take the stock video clip here that I got from Envato Elements of these skater guys here. And so I want to have a freeze frame when he starts to smile. So to create a new sequence from this clip, what I'm going to do is right click and create new sequence from clip. And now it's here in the timeline. So now we're going to trim the clip and find the moment that we want the freeze frame to happen. So I'm just going to scrub through here. And I think the moment here when he has this nice big smile on his face is exactly where I want the freeze frame to happen. So to do this, we're going to hit C on our keyboard to create the cut tool. And we're just going to cut directly at this moment. The next step is to create a freeze frame of this moment. This is where we're going to select this export frame icon. And if you do not see this here from your program panel here, you're going to click on this button editor. So you can select it and then drag it into the menu here and then hit OK. So let's select export frame. And this is where you will export this as a PNG file. You can also choose from different files, but I'm going to use PNG and I will just call this still demo for the demo. And also be sure to import this into your project panel. So after you hit OK, it will appear over here as a still. So if I double click, you can see that this is just a still of him smiling. Now, there are two ways to create the freeze frame effect, and that is to basically insert it between these two clips. So I'm just going to go back to my selection tool and I will just separate out this clip and drag and drop this still in here. So now for a moment, we will just have him still between these two clips. So you can see he is frozen and then it plays again. Now, this is fine and all, but we need to add some more dynamism. We need to cut him out. Now, this first method requires using the masking tool. So if I move this timeline down a bit and we go up to the effect controls panel, from opacity, we can actually use the pen tool here to actually create a mask and click around him to cut him out. Now, the problem with this method is that it takes some time and it's not perfect. You have to zoom in here and it's just kind of clunky to have to do it this way. So rather than using the pen tool, so I'm just going to delete this mask by hitting delete, I'm actually going to use Photoshop. And this is where the Adobe Creative Cloud really shines, because from here, this is the still, it's the .png file that we exported, this still that's here in the timeline. We can right click on it and edit in Adobe Photoshop. And this automatically pulls it open as its own layer. Now this is where we can use the quick selection tool to select just this guy and separate him from the background. So this is where you'll just click on an area and you'll see that it starts to select everywhere that you move, which is much better than having to outline around the guy in Premiere Pro. Now we can zoom in on this area here and you can see that it kind of went outside. So if you click back to W, which is the quick selection tool, and hit the Alt or the Option key, you'll see it becomes a minus symbol and you can subtract the area that you don't want selected. So you'll just go around and just quickly select the entire figure of this guy. Just go through quickly right now and do that. I can't help stopping stare. Show me what you got. I hope you came prepared right there. Cause when you're messing with someone like me, get checked. Alright, so now that I have it selected, what we want to do is separate the selection from the background. So to do that, I'm going to hit Command J on my keyboard or Control J if you're on a PC. and you can see it creates a second layer. And if I turn off the visibility of the first layer, you can see he's cut out. Now it's not perfect here. You can see some of the edges are jagged. Now we could use the eraser tool to just go in and refine some of these rough, bumpy areas here around his dreads, because that's not perfect. But we don't really need it to be perfect, and I'll tell you why. Because we're going to apply a cartoonish stamp effect to this layer. So we're gonna go up to Filter, go to Sketch, and select Stamp. And then this is where you can go in and you can increase the smoothness or decrease it. I'm going to decrease it because I want as much detail as possible, and you can refine this however much you like. I like more details because I like to see the lines in his face more. So I'm gonna have it around 41, then hit OK. Now I want to add kind of an outline around him. So to do that, I'm going to select the effects down here and select Stroke. And this will just add a nice little outline, which I can increase, which is way too much. So I'm just gonna have it around 5, then hit OK. Now this is where the magic starts to happen. So now I'm going to save this as a PSD file. So I'm gonna hit File, Save As, and I'll just save it as still-demo.psd into my stills folder that I created, and hit Save. Now this is where I'm going to import this into my project panel. And to do that, I'm just going to go up to Import, and I'm going to go to Stills and import the still demo PSD, this one right here, and hit OK. And then I'm going to merge all the layers, hit OK. And now we have this still, which has a transparency layer behind it. And I'm going to drag and drop it to replace this still that we have here in our sequence. So just drag and drop this on top, like so, and now we have him here cut out. And now we can just delete this frame behind him, and we can put in a cool color mat behind it. So go to New Item from the Project Panel, and let's create a color mat. I'm going to make a nice bright orange color, like so. I think that looks pretty good, and hit OK. And now I can just drag and drop this here, and I will place it behind this clip. And so now we have him cut out with this colorful background. So now when we play it back, he freezes like so and plays on. So now we want to add some dynamism here. So I'm just going to roll this edit back because we don't need too much of him playing before. Delete that space like so. So now we have him just for a moment, and then freeze frame. And then we can roll this clip back again here. So now this is where music comes into play. Now I have this great music track that I got from MusicBed that I had in the intro. So I'm just gonna drag and drop that down here. And this is where I take this audio layer and I expand it out. Make sure your audio waveforms are visible, because this is where you can start to edit to the beat of the music. If you do not see the audio waveforms here, you can always go up to the wrench tool and go to Show Audio Waveform. If that's unchecked, you'll see your audio like this. But this is super beneficial to have them on. So at this beat here, we want it to zoom in. So to do that, we're going to hit C on our keyboard for the razor cut tool, cut there, and then at this moment, we want it to cut again. So this little section right here, we want to zoom in. So we go up to the effect controls, and we'll just scale him up a bit and move him down like so. So then it jumps to make him a bit bigger, and then at this moment we can have him scale in just a little bit more like so, and move him around. So now it's, which is pretty cool. And at this moment, if we want him to scale in a little bit more, again C to cut, and then we'll just select this clip and zoom in even more. So now let's play it back. So you can see it's just kind of a very poppy, beaty music, so it works well. So now this is where the hand-painted elements come into play. I was able to add some more dynamism with them. So again, remember I have a full tutorial on these hand-painted elements, how to use them and import them into Premiere Pro. If you go up to Window and you go to Essential Graphics, this is where I installed them. So if I just search hand, you will see after it's done searching that I have these hand-painted elements in HD and 4K. So let's first start with some of these hand-painted elements. Let's say we want like a little pop to happen. I'll just drag and drop this down into my timeline and you'll see I have all these awesome little hand-painted elements to choose from. So let's say I want to have this number 4 here. I'll just go to edit. This is where I'm going to select number 4. And I will change the color to white. And then I can reposition this across and up a little bit, as well as rotate this like so. So it's just next to his head. And as I scrub through, you can see it's just animating nicely like so. And as it zooms in, I can duplicate this layer. So I can hit the Alt Option key, click and drag this up and stagger it. So now I have another copy of it, which I can move over on the left. So it's almost two instances of it, like so. That looks pretty good. And you can add some more hand-painted elements. I also added some text on top of here. I just put in brew. I think brew is kind of like a fun slogan that Dan Mace uses in South Africa. It's what the homies call the other homies. So I'm gonna go up to browse and go down to this HD hand-painted type and drag and drop this on top here. And it'll just take a second to cache, and you can see it says any font HD. I'm gonna change this to say brew. And then I'm gonna change this to be like a blue color so it really pops on screen. And you can see from different textures, I'm gonna change it to the wood stamp texture. So it has kind of this grainy wood-like texture. And then from the placement, I'm going to bring this down over on to the right, and then also rotate this a bit so it's kind of like on the side, and also have a line wiggle enabled so that way it kind of moves up and down. See how it wiggles there? We can also scale this up a bit, so if I want the font to be a bit bigger, you can do that. You can also change this to any font, which is awesome. So what I did was I just hit C to cut this hand-painted type, and then I deleted this extra bit at the end. So then the final effect, once I go back into my project panel, you can see the final effect. I added some more hand-painted elements to refine it, and this is what it looked like. So you can do this to any type of video that you shoot of yourself. You can see I also did it for this skateboarder here. I cut him out in Photoshop the exact same way that I did with this guy here. It's a lot of fun, so have fun with these tools, create some cool freeze frame effects, and I'd love to see the work that you guys are doing.
Thanks so much for watching this tutorial, everyone. If you guys have any questions at all, be sure to leave a comment below and be sure to check out that hand-painted title pack. If you guys are interested in getting one-on-one sessions with me, direct message support, free templates, you guys can become a patron. Go to patreon.com/premieregal and I'll see you guys there. Thanks again for watching, everyone, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
So today we're going to do this tutorial in a column voice. Pay attention, you stupid fat upper.